metallic? Huh. That's weird, wild stuff.
Peter!
Jeez, MJ!
Come on!
What's going on?
Did you bring your costume to school?
This is the story as we know it right now. Half hour ago, this large monstrosity you see, a man calling himself only the Rhino, literally charged headfirst to Chase Manhattan Bank at Lexington and 55th. We have conflicting reports at this time, but one report states that this Rhino person cracked the bank vault in half, presumably in an attempt to rob the institution. The police arrived on the scene and have been at the standoff you see before you. What you are seeing now is live footage. Oh my god, did you see that? Rhino? Oh my! The Rhino character is literally headbutting parked cars at the police! He's using his head, his own head, as a battering ram with enough... Oh! Oh, step back! With enough force to actually toss entire cars at the police! Bullets seem to be having no effect. These are live images you are seeing right now. We are live and this is a Fox Channel exclusive. The first look at this tremendous chaos as it unfolds. Right now, we will attempt to get in tighter to see if we can get a statement from one of the officers on the scene.
This is going on now?
This is going on now.
Wow.
I know. Well, go get him.
Cover for me. I'm going to miss fourth period.
It's French. Who cares?
The French.
No kiss?
No time.
My boyfriend's going to kick your butt!
Everyone, back! Back!
Aunt May?
Hello, sweetie.
What are you doing here?
What are you doing here? Why aren't you in class?
I have study hall now.
Then why aren't you studying?
Wait, why are you here?
I have a teacher-parent meeting.
You do?
I do.
With who?
With your teacher.
Since when?
I told you about this.
You did not.
I thought I did.
Did I do something wrong?
Did you?
Who is it with?
May Parker?
I am she, and you must be Mr. De Palma, Peter's math teacher.
Oh, hello, Peter.
Yeah, hi. What's going on?
This is fateful. Why don't you both come in?
What? No, I gotta,
I think it would be very good for all of us to discuss this together.
Come, Peter.
Don't get me wrong, Mrs. Parker. Peter is a teacher's dream student. His natural cognitive abilities are matched perfectly by his creativity and his healthy attitude, not only towards learning, but of the classroom environment. The reason I called you down here, Mrs. Parker, is that over the semester, I've noticed that Peter seems distracted. Rather, unfocused. And though it hasn't affected his studies yet, I thought it was worth talking about before the damage is done. Peter has the possibility of a free ticket to the college of his choice. And I'd hate to have this sophomore slump do anything to jeopardize that. I thought maybe a dialogue would help figure out why Peter seems so...
Peter?
Hmm? What?
Your teacher wants to know why you seem so distracted.
I seem distracted? See, the thing is that I'm supposed to be in study hall helping this foreign exchange student with his chemistry. I promised Mr. Friedkin that I would. And now I feel all guilty that I'm not where I'm supposed to be.
Oh, well, why didn't you say something?
I tried, but...
So, go!
It's okay?
Go.
You're not mad?
Of course not.
Sure?
I'll see you at dinner, sweetie.
So So I said, I'm the principal, and I say we never use a... Hey! Hey! Get back in class, whoever you are!
Hope he's on the track team.
Well, it's hard to say from our vantage point, Dan. But there does seem to be some kind of declaration being made by this rhino person. We can't hear what he's saying, but he's yelling quite viciously at the police. Something... Obviously someone said something to anger him even more than he already was.
Is this still going on?
For this, they stop my stories?
I can't believe this!
You're not allowed back here.
God, are you okay? Gwen! Gwen, what happened?
Nothing.
Are you hurt? Did someone hurt you?
No. I'm fine.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
What are you doing?
Loving life. Don't worry, Pete. I'm a tough chick. I'll be fine.
Oh, okay then.
Yeah. Go ahead. Everybody else leaves me. You go too. Go right ahead.
Gwen. Hey. What's going on?
I think my mom is leaving. My mom is leaving my dad. And she's leaving me.
I don't think...
I heard her on the phone to one of her idiot friends. I heard her, Peter. I heard her say she hates her life. And she's going to leave.
Maybe... I don't know. Maybe she was just venting. You know, blowing off steam.
I heard her say the words. My life in this house sickens me. I hate the people life stuck me with.
Oh.
My own mother hates me!
Come on, Gwen. Let's get up out of the smelly garbage.
No, I'm fine right here.
Please, Gwen, let's just...
I'm fine right here!
Gwen, I want to talk with you, but I have to go. I have to do something really important.
Fine. Fine, Peter.
It's just that... Hey! Let's hang out after school. You want to? Just talk and...
Let's go. It's okay.
I'll find you after school. I promise.
Peter?
I know!
You're still here?
I know. I'm trying. This place is like...
Go! That freak tossed a bus into a Starbucks!
Go to the dumpsters and get Gwen.
What?
Gwen is crying. I left her. I had to. Go in...
She's in a dumpster?
That's where I... Yes!
God, she's such a drama queen!
Go!
You go!
My spider sense. Why would my spider sense... Great, Spider Sense. Thanks a lot. This is one I would have figured out on my own.
Prepare for the Atomic Wedgie to end all Atomic Wedgies, Parker!
Come on. Come on. Come on, Grandma. Go! Go! Can't wait to get my license so I can sit in this all day. Oh my god! I'm coming!
As you can hear, the reaction on the street is jubilance. Jubilance and gratitude for a selfless hero. The invincible Iron Man has easily bested this mysterious monstrosity that inflicted himself on our city. We're gonna see if we can get a statement from our Golden Knight in shining armor.
And what were you doing? Where were you 10 minutes ago?
At least I tried.
Next in line.
Hi, I'm having trouble with my ATM card.
What kind of problem, sir?
It won't give me my money.
Let me see what I can... Mr. Ulrich. Ulrich? You're not the reporter Ben Ulrich?
Yes, I am.
Well, I would shake your hand. Well, you're the guy from the Daily Bugle. You wrote the piece that took down the Kingpin?
Thanks. I just wrote a series of articles. The law is what took-
You, sir, are a prince.
Oh, well, thank you.
And brave.
Well...
Taking on a man like the Kingpin? Did you win a prize for that, or... Hey, what do you get paid for something like that?
I'm sorry.
Don't anybody move! You hear me? This is a robbery! You want to get out of here in one piece, you'll do what I say. Now I want everyone, everyone, to lie down on their bellies with their hands behind their heads. Who is the bank manager?
Me, I am.
Hey, what did I say? I said down on the ground with your hands over your fucking heads. What's your name, bank manager?
David Rosenberg.
Nice to meet you, David Rosenberg.
No, please stop it. Leave him alone!
I want every one of you useless broads to fill a money bag up with the big bills. And I know what a paint can looks like. You people get moving or one of you is next! Nobody else gets hurt if everyone behaves. Get moving now, you useless pieces of crap! Get moving, or I swear to God, I am going to snap someone's neck!
I love ya! I do! I goddammit fucking love ya!
I'll have it typed up in 20 minutes.
And no one else from the press was there?
No one I noticed.
Exclusive! Ha ha! I live for this! Wall crawler shows true colors! No, webbed wonder... No, I had it the first time. I told you, Robbie!
Damn shame, I say.
Give me a break! What has happened to you, Robertson?
Hi, Miss Brandt.
Hey, Peter.
You're turning into some kind of NPR listening ninny!
What's going on?
Nah, that Spider-Man guy robbed a bank. And Jonah's having a Jonah party.
Don't bark at me, Jonah. I can have an opinion.
Who's what?
Hey, I, for one, thought better of this Spider-Man, and...
See, here's the thing, Jonah.
Oh, Lord, Robbie!
Here's the thing, Jonah.
He's a guy in a mask creeping up walls! Now he's a guy in a mask who robbed a bank! The guy has always...
But here's the thing, Jonah.
What?
I'm not entirely sure it's the same Spider-Man as the one who fought Dr. Octopus on TV.
What?
Listen, the guy didn't have the same flair as the one I saw fight Doc Ock. Remember? I was there. The guy I saw fight Doc Ock had a kind of grace to him. Almost like a gymnast. This guy was way less polished and-
Oh, come on!
No, listen-
Come on!
First of all, why would Spider-Man all of a sudden-
Why would a successful football player all of a sudden kill his wife? People turn. Like milk. People turn.
Like milk?
I'm not going through this rigmarole with you again, Urich! Did you or did you not see this piece of Staten Island filth Spider-Man rob a bank?
I saw a guy in a Spider-Man outfit.
Who shoots webs.
Who beat a man. And that just doesn't match the profile which...
Who swung away from the police on his webs?
Listen. I know what I saw, Jonah.
Write the story, Ben!
I just think it's worth...
Write the story!
But we have an obligation...
Write the story!
Fine.
Front page! I want to be able to see this headline from half a mile away! I want a graphic that you could... You. Where are those pictures the kid brought us that time? We'll use one of the kids! Yeah, that's it! That's the ticket! There's your perfect front page! Spider-Man! Criminal!
Putting on my costume and robbing a bank. Congratulations, whoever you are. You knocked the wind right out of me. Doc Ock, the Kingpin, the Green Goblin, and nothing sucked the life right out of me like you did. couldn't even muster the energy to put on my costume and swing home. I know I say to myself, boy, I cannot catch a break. But boy, I cannot catch a break. And Mary Jane. The only person I can unload all this stuff on is MJ. But now I feel that maybe telling her I was Spider-Man was this huge mistake. She still freaked out about Norman Osborn attacking her to get to me. As well as she should be. But there's this wall all up between us or something. But she told Harry she was in love with me. But she never told me. So now what? Do I tell her I'm in love with her? Does she already know? Do I tell her? Do I tell her it was a mistake to involve her in my life as Spider-Man and that I'm sorry? Can you close a door like that on someone after you've opened it? Idiot faked my costume and robbed a bank. I'm going to find that guy and... Oh my god! Aunt May! Oh my god! Oh my god!
I know we hardly know each other, but Gwen and I have no other family, and I promise I would never even dream
of... Well, we single parents have to stick together.
I don't know if I'm cut out to be a single parent.
Oh, please.
I'm scared to death of my own daughter.
And your wife is officially out of the picture now, or...
Looks like...
I'm sorry. That was rude of me, wasn't it?
No. Actually, my wife up and leaving in the middle of the night without even half an explanation was rude. Poor Gwen. She deserves a mother. She deserves better than all this. Plus, I am not looking forward to being single again. Dating again.
Me either. I am a terrible single person. Terrible. Peter.
Hi.
Hi, sweetie. Do you remember Captain Stacy?
Oh, yeah. Hello, sir. Hi.
Did you eat? How was work?
No, but, what's going on?
Well, Captain Stacy here has a police detectives conference in Atlantic City this weekend. So I offered to let your friend, Gwen... stay with us until he gets back.
Oh.
Oh?
Yeah, I know.
She's in the house. Right now.
Yes.
She's sleeping here?
It wasn't my idea.
Why is she here? I mean...
Her mom up and left. And her dad and my aunt are, I guess, friends now all of a sudden, and... Wait. Are you angry at me for this? Hello?
But what exactly am I supposed to think? First, she's just showing up here in the middle of the night, and now she's sleeping over in her pajamas?
Why are you mad at me? I don't like her. I like you.
I just think it's very inappropriate.
What is? I'm not going to do anything with her. Do you not trust me?
I don't trust her, okay? Ever since she came here, I've seen what's been going on.
What are you talking about?
She's sleeping over.
Do you want me to tell my aunt to kick her out of here?
Don't you see what I'm...
No! No, I don't! Why are you acting like this?
Did you tell her you were Spider-Man?
No! What are you talking about? That's... You're the only person I've told that to. Well, that was annoying.
Coming up after the break, we talked to a man who knew Captain America way back when and what he...
What did you answer for number 4?
I didn't get to it yet.
I thought MJ was gonna study with us.
Yeah, I don't know what happened there.
Hold on. Yes. We're going to go live to a situation that is developing uptown. We have just received word that Spider-Man has been caught in the middle of a jewelry heist on the Upper West Side. We are going to go live to Shane Jewelers, where Monica Kaufman is already on the scene. Monica, what is the situation down there?
It's a standoff, Dan.
Police have come to the scene here at Shane Jewelers, where a man that has been identified as the mysterious Spider-Man has trapped himself inside the building. Police have made numerous attempts to negotiate with Spider-Man, and there is no word on what the hostage situation is just yet. But it looks like rumors are true. Spider-Man has officially joined the ranks of criminals.
Aunt May, can I run over to Mary's for a second?
Dan, I don't know if you can hear me, but we have talked to sources at the police department, and word from the inside is that the police mood has become increasingly anti-vigilante. We hear that they've been waiting for just a moment like this to prove their point. We're going to stay on the scene.
Make it easy on yourself, and come out with your mask off and your hands up.
Please, guys, allow me. I am dying to have a talk with this guy myself. I know you guys have a job to do, but I really think I can take care of this in two shakes of
Get your hands on your head!
Oh, come on! You are talking to the actual Spider-Man now! Hence, I am not robbing anything in there, and I'm talking to you out here!
You have till the count of three!
Guys, Hello? I am not robbing anything! I don't even have pockets! I am here to help!
Take him down!
Stay down. Stay down.
Don't you move.
Don't you move a muscle or I'll blow your head off.
My shoulder.
You are under arrest.
My shoulder.
You have the right to remain silent.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Not again. Not.
Anything you say can and will be.
No, listen. Ow.
Grab the mask. Let's end this.
No.
Against you in a court.
Stop me. Off me. I didn't do any.
Get him!
Freeze!
Do not move!
Take him down!
That's amazing! The guy took a bullet!
Hit him again!
Oh no! Ow! Oh my god! This can't be it! I've been shot! Oh my god! Spinning! I can't see straight! My mask! Gotta fix my mask! My arm! Please, let me out of this. This can't be how it... Please, out of here. Mary, please. I can't let this be it. Oh, God. Gotta pull it together. Got to get...
There he is.
No.
This is the NYPD. Freeze where you are. Lie on the ground with your hand over your head or we will shoot you.
Jeez, this guy's fast.
Take him down. Now.
Why are we shooting at him? Shouldn't we...
He resisted arrest. He attacked an officer.
The horn said outside the store. I thought he was...
Do your job.
I'm just...
Do your job.
Don't have to yell. I have feelings.
This is Bird 4. We do not have a visual. Repeat, we do not have a visual.
Fuck. Where did he go?
I can't believe you.
I had him in my hands. I had him.
I know.
In my hands.
So I'm gonna have to listen to you whine about this for the rest of my life.
Oh, God. I'm going to throw up. My shoulder's on fire. It's infected already. I've been shot. God, I've been shot. I don't know what to do. I didn't think. I didn't.
Horrible nightmares every night since the bridge incident. The bridge incident. And I'm not a nightmare person. I just don't have them. Am officially freaking out. I think I should see a psychiatrist, but I can't because of Peter. Hello? Oh, hi, Aunt May. Peter? Oh, yeah, he's here. He's in the bathroom. Peter? It's your Aunt May. Yeah? Okay. Yeah, he's... I don't know what he's doing in there. Okay, what time is it now? Oh, yeah. No, I didn't even notice. Okay, I'll tell him. Bye. I should be an actress. Hello?
We have a collect call from Peter Parker. Do you accept the charges? Say yes or no now.
Yes! Oh man, Peter! Your aunt just called looking for you. You have to be home in 45 minutes, she said. She didn't sound ticked, but you don't want to get... Hello? Peter?
Mary. Help me.
You sure this is it, sweetie?
Thanks. Keep the change. Peter? Peter? Oh my god! Oh my god, Peter, what happened?
Not doing so well.
I brought some clothes and some first aid. I didn't know what to bring. I just... Oh my god, Peter. We have to get you to a hospital.
They'll arrest me. I don't know what to do.
We have to call your Aunt May.
No. No, we can't.
We have to.
No. My Uncle Ben... Uncle Ben was shot. This will kill her. I don't know what to do.
I think I do. You remember what I told you?
They'll call the cops.
You have to do this. Just do it. I'll be here. Oh my.
Kid, hey, kid, can you hear me?
Yo, he just came in here and fell over.
Doctor, he's been shot. One shoulder wound.
Oh, man. The kid's a kid.
There's no ID.
Is he with you?
What? No. No, I'm here with
Get him into 402. Stat.
ANO times 4. BP's 132 over 82. Pulse 110.
Number 8 ET2. What's his BP?
Hold on. Pulse OX is low. 82.
Give me 4 units of ONA. Hang 2 on the rapid infuser.
Hey, Mike, has he moved?
Nope, out cold. His vital signs are strong.
Strong? They are through the roof.
Oh, finally, here come the police. Officer?
Dr. Costanza?
Yes, thank you for responding.
What do we got?
We got a John Doe. Kid comes in, gunshot wound to the shoulder.
Came in on the homeboy ambulance service?
At first I thought so, but he's not wearing the same shirt he was shot in.
Wait, he changed his shirt before he came in?
That's what I said. You don't see that every day.
No ID on him?
Nothing. Shirt, pants, that's it.
It's a kid. I'd say 17 years old.
15.
Is he awake?
Not yet. Let him sleep, because we just...
I'm just going to see if I can get a name out of him so we can process up.
Ted, call Frank on the third floor. We got an MIA.
I was standing here the entire... I swear, I never left this spot. I swear, we never left him alone.
Hey, did a patient come through here? Hello? Any of you? Anybody see a patient come through here? Doc, lock the ward down and call your security force down here. Now.
This is ER4. I need as many security guards as you have on duty. And call up to psych and see if they can spare any order. Hey, you! Yeah, you! Hey, stop! Did you see a girl?
No.
Was she hot?
Ow!
Oh my god, I'm going to faint.
Just get me home first. What?
I can see your tushy.
Give me my pants and my web shooters.
Can you swing us home?
NJ, I'm whacked out on painkillers. I don't think I can find my house.
I don't have any more money for a cab.
Do you have an ATM card?
Yeah, yes, my savings.
I'll pay you back, just get me home.
Oh, thank God you're all right.
How?
Well, Max, a lot of people don't know that I am, in fact, dating Julia Roberts. It's true. And it's true, folks. Julia and I have a secret love child.
Oh my God. Peter!
Officials are asking anyone with legitimate information about the man who calls himself Spider-Man to please come forward. Sergeant Bullitt, there is a rumor that Spider-Man was successful in his robbery attempt tonight, even though witnesses say he didn't actually seem to have any of the stolen...
Let me make myself perfectly clear. Vigilante behavior will not be tolerated in this city, masked or otherwise. We've been lenient on people like this Spider-Man, but those days are over. Clearly, he is a coward and a thief. He wears a mask, and now we know why. Don't you worry. This Spider-Man weasel will pay for what he's done here tonight.
Ow.
Should I open with that joke I told you?
No.
What?
You're my captain, Captain, and I respect you, but if you open with that joke, half the cops in the convention hall will pull out their revolvers and...
You laughed at it when
What Burke is trying to say, Captain Stacy, is that joke-telling is an art form, and not everyone...
But you laughed.
He was kissing your butt, sir.
I was kissing butt.
I can tell a joke.
Drop the guard, and put your hands over your head. I mean it.
I'm not giving you to the count of three.
Do it now!
I was really excited for you this weekend. Animal Farm is about as perfect a piece of writing as was ever created. It works as both a gripping piece of fiction and as an allegory. Does anybody know what I mean when I use the word allegory? Anyone? Peter Parker, would you like to maybe wake up and tell the class what an allegory is?
What?
Are you okay, Peter?
Actually, no. Not feeling that well.
Would you like to go to the nurse?
Yeah, maybe.
Go then.
Can I take him?
He's a big boy, Mary Jane.
I'm not feeling well either. Can I go to the nurse?
Kong, from the book, name me one of the seven commandments that the animals painted in big white letters on the barn.
What? Animals painting? What kind of book is this?
Oh, man. What am I doing? I could be dying for all I know. I mean, I got shot last night. An actual cop shot me in the arm with an actual bullet. And here I am in class, pretending everything is fine. I am insane. I need sleep. I need to lie down. I need a doctor. But if I even tried to stay home sick from school, Aunt May would totally have checked me out and seen the huge bandage on my shoulder. And I'm a good song and dance man, but I don't think I can talk my way out of a gunshot wound. I can't believe how badly I got my... Well, my spider sense isn't tingling or whatever it does when I'm about to get pounced on. If this is Norman Osborn, I quit.
Peter?
Yeah?
Hi. My name is Janet Van Dyne. Nick Fury sent me. We were all watching TV last night and saw what happened with you and the cops. Tough breaks. Nick figured you might need a doctor who specialized in genetics. Who made house calls?
Yeah, well, I don't need Nick Fury's help.
Yes, you do.
Yeah, I do. Hey, wait, you're the
Wasp, yeah. Card-carrying member of the Ultimates. Hey, that's not too bad at all, healing nicely. Do you have an increased cellular chemokine interleukin 8 or IL-8?
I got bit by a spider.
Do you have an increased healing factor?
I don't know, but I think so. I haven't done any molecular research on it because my basement microscope only has four DIN objectives, and...
I remember those.
Wait, what's that?
This will, hopefully, heal you at an even more accelerated rate. They discovered a chemical in chickens called CCAF that can increase healing time in humans. One of the things we've been working on in our free time is a specific genetic cocktail based on a synthesis of the patient's own blood sample and the chemokines. So I whipped up an interesting little cocktail from your own very unique blood sample.
What's... Ow! How did you calibrate my molecular levels if I never gave you a blood sample?
Look at you, you are smart! That's cute. I don't know, Nick Fury had a blood sample from you. Consider yourself lucky this happened on TV and that we were watching. Listen, you may or may not get some flu-like symptoms, but they'll pass. Just try to take it easy for a couple of days.
Did Fury happen to mention anything to you about a guy named Harry?
Harry? No.
Fury didn't happen to mention if he knows who that guy is that is running around impersonating me and robbing banks?
No, he didn't say. And no offense, kiddo, but that kind of thing is small potatoes for us. But I tell you, if someone was running around in my costume doing that, I would find him and beat the holy snot out of him.
You know what? You look a million times better than you did in class.
I feel a million times better.
You do?
I really do.
Oh, come on.
What?
Drop the act, man. That was the lamest sick routine I have ever seen. Eric Roberts laughs at you.
That's okay. That's nothing compared to the real put-on you guys are putting on.
Come on. I totally know. The two of you are sneaking around in the middle of the night. Dude, you came in at 1 a.m. I heard you. If my dad caught me out with a guy at 1 a.m, he would lock me in a tower like that chick in that movie. Hey, listen, good for you guys, but you're gonna get busted. Everyone gets busted, eventually. What?
Aunt May! Oh no!
Hi, I'm Ben Ulrich, reporter for the Daily Bugle. Did you happen to see what went on here today?
Yo, man, not for nothing, but I was taking out the garbage, and I hear all this noise coming from behind the bank over there. It wasn't no explosion or nothing, just like a car accident. That sound, like a squeal, then a thump.
A thump?
Like when a car hits something. And all of these cops up in here for the convention, they start running around. It was crazy. You'd think Godzilla was up in here.
No, I was standing right over there. See? Right there. And I saw Spider-Man. And he was trying to rip off an armored car, which really... See, I remember being really bummed out because I thought Spider-Man was one of the good guys. But like everyone else, I guess he was full of it. And then there he is, beating the crap out of this poor guard. He was standing right on top of the armored car that tipped over and he was just slapping the guard. Slapping him, and all these cops came out of nowhere and were pointing their guns and screaming and yelling, just like on a TV.
What did Spider-Man do?
What kind of an idiot tries to rob an armored car at a cop convention? I mean, think about it.
What did Spider-Man do?
What'd he do? The crumb-bum makes a run for it. All the cops got their guns out and this spider dude, he just bolts.
It was just about the scariest thing I ever saw. All these cops were running and screaming, and the Spider-Man guy, he was running across the rooftop of that restaurant over there. Over there. See? There. He was running across the rooftop, swearing at the cops in Spanish.
In Spanish?
Yeah, I know. I always assumed that he was, like, white or something, but I guess it was pretty racist of me now that I think about it.
And that's when the cops started firing?
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
So, basically this guy Ben, who is this reporter friend I have at the paper, he said the same thing those cop friends of your dad said. That everyone who saw what happened, every one of them said he died saving that little boy. He died a hero. And I know that doesn't make it any better, but that's what happened. They don't know what was in the knapsack yet, but they think it was stuff to open the armored car with. Blow it up or something. Maybe that plastique stuff, that Play-Doh they make bombs with.
Spider-Man.
And, they don't know if it was really Spider-Man or a guy pretending to be. A lot of the witnesses say, they think that it's a guy pretending to... Yeah. Well, they said that in the craziness of what was going on, that the guy probably ditched the costume and slipped into the crowd and such.
You guys mind? I like to be alone for a while.
Don't talk to me! Yurich! Just go! Go, go, go! Ben, take a photographer with you!
No time, Jonah. Send one down. Meantime, I have my digital.
Call the second you have anything!
Always do.
Told you, Robbie! Told you!
Hey, Mr. Robertson.
Oh, hi, Peter. I thought you weren't coming in today.
What's going on?
Oh, that idiot dressing up as Spider-Man got himself into another standoff with the police. I tell you, Peter, I sincerely hope that this isn't the same Spider-Man, and I sincerely hope whoever this reckless maniac is, I hope they put this guy away for all time. But you gotta give this moron one thing. When's the last time you've seen an old-fashioned, honest-to-goodness crime spree like this? I mean... Okay... Too young to be mumbling to myself. Captain DeWolf.
I seen him.
I thought we were here because Spider-Man was already...
I seen him!
Hi. I'm looking for Ginger Stacy. Oh, hi. Hello. Yes. I'm May Parker. My nephew? No. We don't know each other. My nephew is in the same grade as your daughter? Yes. I don't know if anyone has been in touch with you, but... Yes. Well, I can't tell you how sorry I am about your husband's passing. I didn't know Captain Stacy all that well, but he struck me as a fine man, and, well, the reason I'm calling is that your daughter, Gwen, is staying here. She, well, no, as a favor to your husband, she was staying here while he was away, and... Well, I was wondering when you were going to be coming back for her. Your daughter. She needs her mother now. She... But you're her mother. She just lost her... I just can't imagine why you would... I hope this is the grief talking and not who you really are. Because what you are saying is just about the most horrible... Hello?
I'll do it! I'll kill this dumb broad right here! Right in front of all these people! I'm not scared of you! I'm not! You back away from here! You go out the way you came! You You crawl right up that wall and you get out of here! Or I'll do it! I mean it! Come here, murderer! Oh no. Ow! You murdered someone today! A cop! A good person! Do you know that? Do you even know what you've done? You murdered someone! You dressed up like me, and you murdered someone! Did you think I wasn't going to do anything about it? For what? For money? For attention? Yeah! Get away from me! Get away! What is this about? Do you even know? People think I murdered a man! People think I stole! They don't trust me now, and for what? For what reason? Get away! Okay. I know you're mad. I can understand that. I was just... Take the money! Go ahead. Take it. I see people like you on TV. Idiots running around the city, grabbing whatever they can. Ugh, come on! Like they live in a movie! Like they can do whatever they want! I'm serious. Take the money. Just take it! Why my costume, huh? Why?
Come on, what are you-
Ow! Why me?
I just thought it was a cool gimmick. It was nothing personal. I swear, it wasn't- Please, I'm just some guy.
Just some guy? The world thinks I'm a murderer now! All these people are sitting here fearing for their lives, praying that they get to go home to their families, just so some guy can try to steal some money! So some guy can pretend to be famous because he puts on a costume! No. So what's to stop me from murdering you? Huh? Why not? What difference would it make? Tell me you don't deserve it! Tell me why I shouldn't kill you right here!
Captain DeWolf, what's the call?
This is Captain Jean DeWolf of the NYPD. I want anyone wearing a Spider-Man costume to come out with your mask off and your hands over your head!
Oh my god!
He did it. He really did it.
Who did it? Did what?
We were so lucky. So lucky.
What happened?
I did it. It was all me. I did it. I can prove it in everything. Please just get me out of here. I promise. It was me and me alone. Please. Damn it! I lost it. I completely lost it. I didn't even know I could get that angry. It just creeped up on me. I didn't even realize it was happening. I could have killed him. Killed a man with my bare hands. Then what would I be? I can't even think about it. I just have to make sure. I can never let anything even remotely like that happen again. I have to remind myself why I do this in the first place. Uh-oh. Aunt May?
We have to talk. It's about Gwen. Gwenny? Sorry we woke you, but...
Oh, sorry.
No.
Gwen. Hey. They got the guy. The guy in the Spider-Man costume. They got him.
Where are you going?
Well, I guess home. To get some of my things. And, I have an aunt in Minnesota. My mom's sister, who I actually have never met in person, and I don't think they'll be that happy to see me.
And no other family?
Nope. All the grandparents are dead. And it wasn't that big of a family to begin with.
How are you getting to Minnesota?
Don't know. I don't even know where Minnesota is on a map.
Well, I have an offer. Peter and I, we talked about it. Maybe your mom will come around. I don't know. I don't know her. But seeing as how I really only know how to cook for three, and seeing as we really think the world of you, we were hoping that maybe you'd consider staying here. You know, if you want. It's okay.
I killed my daddy.
It's okay. It's okay.
So, I guess, I don't know. I guess we're going to move her stuff in and see what happens.
Uh-huh.
What? What?
This isn't it. I thought that this would be it, but it isn't.
What are you talking about?
Us! This isn't what I thought it was going to be.
Just because Gwen is moving into my house? What are you talking about?
No, that's...
I can't believe you!
How about because I wake up in the middle of the night, every night, crying? Did you know that? I have nightmares, Peter. Horrible nightmares that you die, or I die every night. Do you know that I relive the bridge thing? I keep reliving the moment, the exact moment when I was just thrown, tossed off the top of the Queensboro Bridge. Sometimes it happens when I'm awake right in the middle of class. I'm sitting in class and I'll start falling. At first, it was cool. My boyfriend is a superhero. Oh my god, my boyfriend's... But Peter, you're going to die doing this. You're going to die in that stupid costume. And I know that there is nothing I can say to stop you from doing it. But I never in a million years imagined that I would be tossed off a bridge by a maniac or wiping your gunshot blood off my clothes so my mom doesn't see it. Someone is going to kill you. I can't do this.
This? Hey, no! All of a sudden you think this. You never told me any of this. This is about Gwen.
Peter, you're right. Yes, on top of the fact that our lives have become this nightmare that Spider-Man puts us through. On top of that, now you are living with this girl who is so pretty and interesting, and she's in love with you, Peter.
No.
She is. I'm not stupid, I know.
God, her father just died.
One has nothing to do with the other. My mom sits in our kitchen year after year and pretends that my dad doesn't cheat on her. When everyone on the planet knows that he does. He stays out all night and comes home drunk and he stinks like a brothel. And she just pretends everything is just fine and I promised myself that I wasn't going to do that. I promised myself that I wasn't going to play some stupid game where I tricked myself into thinking that everything is okay when it's not. I can't do it, Peter. I'm not stupid.
Well, I didn't know that about your dad, did I?
Peter, you never ask. You never ask about me. It's all about you and your costume. And it was fun in the beginning, sure.
How am I supposed to know this about your dad and mom if you don't tell me? I'm supposed to read your mind?
For the record, it's not just Gwen. It's all of it. I love you, Peter. I just can't do this.
So what? We're done?
Yeah.
Before